This place has inspired me my entire life. When I was a little girl, I dreamed I could fly like a bird. I would soar over lush mangroves to the sea, float over a mosaic of shallows, then dive beneath the surface and glide along the reef. On my first visit to the hammock, my father told me that before I would be allowed to explore, I had to sit in one place and count as many creatures as I could.
I'll be right over here, honey. Don't worry.
Only calm and quiet, he said, would allow me to see the hidden wonders around us. At the time, sitting quietly in one place was almost impossible. But my father was right, and patience paid off. At first, even with my dad, the mangroves felt eerie and strange. The place felt almost frozen in time, yet wherever I looked, the mangroves fostered life. The world beneath the surface called to me, but I wasn't sure at first. It appeared a dark, unknown place. Thank you. Time and experience bred confidence, and soon I ventured from the sanctuary of the mangroves to the open seagrass beds. The seagrass was a haven for some, a hunting ground for others. For me, it was a place of continual discovery. This vast undersea meadow stretches out to where many of these creatures would eventually live out their lives. Growing up in a place surrounded by water, it gradually became a part of me, and I a part of it. Life on the reef was beyond my wildest imagination. The reef is the heart of the Keys. It gives life, but it claims it too. Hidden by coral, the bones of long-forgotten ships rest here, providing a home for those who survive by agility, camouflage, and stealth. Much of life on the reef is out of sight. Under ledges is a secret world. Thank you. on the reef, one moment I could be surrounded by life. The next, feel completely alone. Given their size, I've always been amazed at how a Goliath grouper can appear out of nowhere. It was always so nice to see one. The massive fish were once nearly wiped out by overfishing. But a no-catch policy was well enforced. And Goliaths are rebounding from their backwater nurseries to once again patrol the reefs. The grouper population isn't the only one that has grown over recent years. Big changes swept down the Keys as isolated islands once visited only by boat were connected by rail, and not long after, by road. A wide range of traditional fisheries that went back generations took a back seat as real estate development and tourism began to boom, creating their own impact on local ecosystems. It would take many years before we fully understood the implications of such development. More and more people made their way to the Keys. Most came to enjoy the beauty and climate of the islands, others to seek riches or refuge. Many stayed. These growing numbers presented new challenges in managing the Keys' unique environment. Learning to balance enjoyment with responsibility became an ever-evolving struggle. Staring into the endless blue of open water can be mesmerizing. Like a siren, it calls you deeper. This place has inspired me my entire life. It has been my home, my playground, my studio. The Keys have been many things to many people. And I've come to understand that while each of us takes away from this place something unique, it is our common responsibility to make choices that guarantee a quality of life for all living things.